actually gone through this and cleaned it out. Due to my setup, my purse is going to be right here, and I'm just going to kind of pull things out and put them to the side. So I hope that's okay. So yeah, I think this is the same purse that I had last time I filmed this video, probably. But it's just an owl purse. Strap, and I really like it, but I'm going to be switching purses soon, so I need to get everything cleared out, and it'll be nice to carry something that doesn't weigh 50 pounds around. So yeah, let's go ahead and get started. If I pull out any receipts or papers or anything like that, then if it's not anything too weird, then I'll read it to you. It's probably going to be like grocery lists and things like that in here. Piece of paper, first thing. I'm hoping that wasn't too loud. This is just a list from Walmart and Dollar Tree. From Walmart, we got water, we got cat litter, shampoo, disinfecting wipes, cups, plates, and Gatorade. And then from Dollar Tree, oh, just to show how old this is, I have a Mother's Day card on here from Dollar Tree. So, May. Anyway, dental floss, Mother's Day card, a calendar, spoons, and a Frisbee. So that's what we picked up from Dollar Tree. I have a feeling this is going to be a very long video. I don't even like want to show you guys the inside because it's just like to the top with crap. The next thing we have is just a pack of wipes, and Lexi and Savannah are always with us, so these come in handy. I bought these a few months ago from Dollar Tree, and I really like them. So I basically got a trash pile and then a pile of stuff that I'm keeping. Yeah. There's so much stuff in here. I'm disgusted with myself that it's taken me this long to clean this thing out. Inside of papers. That's how bad this is. This is just, I'm not showing it on camera because it is a bank receipt, so it's got my name and stuff on it, so I don't want to show that. But this, let's see what this is. I don't even know. Oh, this is a, if you shop at Walmart a lot, you probably know about their what is it called? Some kind of savings, shopper savings or something, where you scan your receipt and then it, savings catcher, that's what it's called. And it, like, it matches prices different places. So this is just, our little card that we had money put on. I don't know, I'm horrible at explaining it. But if you shop at Walmart, then you know what that is. Basically, if you purchase something and it costs less at another store, they give you that money back, and they kind of put it on like a little temporary card. You can print that card out and take it back to Walmart and get like if you have $10, you can get $10 off a purchase or whatever. So that's what that is. And I can already tell this is the first page to that. Yeah, so I'm not going to open it because it's the same thing. It was just two pages. This is crazy. just thought it would be nice to have them. All right. This is a box of allergy relief medication. It's empty though. And I know that half of it has spilled out in my purse because I saw that the other day. So we'll get to that. Why I go so long without cleaning this thing out. I am like obsessed with having my house clean, but when it comes to my purse, I don't know what it is. But clean house, clean car, like it just has to be like that. But my purse is a different story. This is just one of those little fragrance strips from Rue 21. It still smells good. And it's just like when you go up and you want to test the fragrance and you spray it on there. That's what that was. This is another Walmart list. We purchased cat litter, dry food, and wet food for the cats. Water, bleach, bathroom spray, disinfectant wipes, paper towels, toilet paper, cups, and chapstick. That was supposed to go in the box. I'm tempted to throw them away, but I guess I'll keep them. I don't know. I need to see when this expires, because let's see. I don't see an expiration date, and that's not good. Like 90% of the stuff we pick up, if it's like allergy stuff and headache stuff, we get from Dollar Tree because they have really good stuff and you wouldn't think to get it from there, but it's good. I like it. It works for me. Yeah, I don't see an expiration date on this. So I think I'm gonna throw it away. I got it in the spring when my allergies were really bad, so it's not like it's, you know, a year old, but if it doesn't have a date on it, then I need to throw it away. This is my wallet. That looks horrible. I think I said in the last What's in My Purse video that I needed to get a new wallet, and that has not happened. So, more allergy medication. My iPod. Now, this is in a side pocket. This thing is so old. This is like the original classic that I've had since like 2007, but this is my baby. I take this with me everywhere. I haven't been listening to it as much as I used to. Since we got our new car, we have Sirius Radio, and I've been obsessed with that. So I've been listening to that mostly, but then at night I listen to my iPod. So, oh goodness. No, this is just a, somebody gave me a real estate card. I guess that's what it is. I don't know. She's like a real estate agent. We were at Shane's Rib Shack and they had this thing back in May where, no, I think it was the last day of April. Yeah, it was April. The last day in April where the first 100 people in line got like a free half slab of ribs, toast, and a drink. And we do that almost every year if we're here in town. And so we were in line and she was just passing out her card. So I took one, but it's not like I need it. I'm not planning on moving or anything. This is a lint roller, and I know that it looks disgusting, but that's only because my purse, like the inside, is black and it just gets all of the fuzz and everything from there. It's not as bad as it looks. Even though I have a lot of stuff in here, it's not dirty. It's mostly paper and things like that. Just putting that out there. This is my camera, and I definitely need to put that back. I keep that in there because I mentioned this in a previous video, but sometimes I take pictures of real estate, and sometimes they text me, and I have to be able to go to the location within like an hour. text me or send me an email while I'm out that I can just go to the property and I don't have to come back home and get my camera. My cell phone is, I'm thinking, from 2009, believe it or not. I'm not big into upgrading things unless I really need it, and the picture quality is not very good on there, so I had to invest in a new camera, and that's the camera. I think everyone has one of these, probably, and this is empty right now. Chris and I were putting our multivitamins in there every day, and I just kind of stopped doing that, but I need to go back to doing that because I like taking them at lunch every day. And yeah, I mentioned, gosh, I don't even know how long ago it was, that I've always had a really hard time taking multivitamins, and they just make me sick. I don't know what it is about them. I physically get sick after about, I don't know, 20 minutes after taking one. But I recently tried Kroger's brand, just the Kroger brand, and they are working really well so far. And I'm glad, because it's not that I didn't want to take vitamins. I've always wanted to, but there's just been something in them that made me sick, and Kroger's brand does not. So, shout out to Kroger and your women's multivitamins. My neighbors are being so loud. They keep starting their cars up and then turning them off, starting them up and turning them off, and I don't know why. Oh, yummy. This is a receipt for Cracker Barrel, and I love that place so much. This was from April 25th, and we stopped here on our way out of town to go to North Carolina, and I remember this. We ate with my parents, and my favorite thing to get there, all-time favorite, is a kid's hamburger. So I had a kid's hamburger, and what did I get for my side? I don't know. It doesn't say. I think I got macaroni and cheese. I think. I'm a big kid. So, yeah, I got a kid's hamburger and macaroni and cheese. And then Chris got their baked chicken, which he really likes. I think that was like their daily special or something, if I'm not mistaken. Got a pen. You always need a pen. And I have a couple of those in there. Or at least I should. This is a receipt for, oh my gosh, okay, this is a receipt for a Japanese steakhouse where they did like a bocce, and we have a place here that is just incredible, and their prices are super cheap. You can get like steak and chicken, and they do it all in front of you, and I think it's like $11.99. This place I went to, because my sister wanted to go. We went there for lunch. It was just myself, my sister, Lexi, and Savannah. For my meal alone, with tip, it was almost $30. I was so mad. I told my sister, I was like, no, never again. Because I cannot afford to spend $30 on lunch. Like, that's crazy to me. I mean, if it was like a special occasion, yeah, but just like a random, just, yeah, let's go get lunch. I'm so, I don't want to say cheap, but I like saving money, and I just, yeah.